Hello and welcome back to Torunga's channel. Today I want to show you the next of the freelancers. This freelancer is called the Freelancer Max, and you see it is a little bit beefier. It can carry quite a bit more of load, and it's of course wider, and it pays, according to description, with having less armament. So let's get down and look at it up close. And of course I'll jump here again over the flowers, and then let's go down just here. There we go. So the entrance is the same way as on the other freelancers on the front, and has a nice animation walking in. Cockpit area pretty much the same, unchanged from the normal freelancer. Freelancer Dur of course looks a little bit different. It has these antennas and these housings for the extra radar in the front. And yeah, this is pretty much the same here. You can sit down in the pilot seat. Nice animation there. The other seats work just the same way. Also inside, all the design exactly the same as in the normal freelancer. That is true, the same here for the lavatory, shower combo, and here also the sink, and of course here whatever these tables are, radar or navigation, we don't know yet, it's not implemented yet. So let's get them back up. If you look down here and go for use, you just walk back out where it came in. Here's the docking area again, and it has exactly the same dock, and that's where the similarities really end, because if I go into this cargo bay, as it is significantly wider, about twice as wide, and I'm pretty sure that it's two of these kind of almost like rails here, and that has probably something to do with standard cargo containers, much like you would see in modern day airplanes where they have standard containers they use for transport. And this hatch of course also way bigger, works exactly the same way. We also have that turret here on the back, and the difference I believe is probably in the rockets it can hold, how many. I think the wings were wider on the normal and on the Dur version of the Freelancer, and it could just hold more rockets, because these guns are exactly the same as on the other Freelancers. And here in the front, nice wear. I really like the paint job there they did. And of course it is missing these two bays for the extra radars or scanners. So I wish I could fly it, but that sadly enough is not working. Now the lighting, I don't know if they did something about it, because it seems to be brighter, but that's probably just wishful thinking there. So here we can close it back up. Did you see that animation of the ramp actually folding into this hatch? It's really nice, because you can see through and you really see how that extends from the inside coming out. So very nice level of detail. Same thing here with these clamps, they are really nicely done. And yeah, I like it. Hydraulics here working all nicely. This is a little bit very shiny here up here. It actually, if you look at it, it reflects the hangar outside, but we're actually closed, so it shouldn't reflect that. Interesting. So but that's just a minor bug. This hatch we cannot use yet, we can't get the ladder down or anything. And in here We looked at the sleeping animation, sitting down here on the back row seats. That's a little bit more comfortable than driving with uncle or something into the vacation, mom and dad. So have a little home cinema here so the kids don't get bored in the family trip. And of course you can send them also to sleep. Kids sleep on the bottom because it has a curtain. So yes, and down here we have some cargo containers. That's probably just for clothing or something. Alright, the sink is not implemented with functionality yet. However, you can open and close this door, and then you can also open that toilet. There we go. Toilet down. Yep. So that's about it what we can animate here. Let's take another look from the back, from above. So up here, next elevator going up to the office. They have to put in some elevator music, that would be really funny. And that's the view from the office. The homepage again to look a little bit at the stats of the Freelancer Max. And aside from a few photos, which is interesting here is that we actually have two free wingtip mounts, max size 3, that are not used. So that's something interesting to look at. Then of course we have the big guns on the side. Unmanned turrets is what they're called. Manned turrets in the back. It has that S1, so it's just a small one. Then it has an S4 shield. And it has an additional equipment slot. In this case, the jump engine, of course, because you want to jump and transport things into other systems. So how does it compare to the other ones? Now, in the description it says that that variant has extra cargo. Of course, it's the Freelancer Max. It's the whole point of it. And if we look what that actually means, it has 123 cargo capacity compared to 52 that the other ones have. It also uses two persons like the normal Freelancer Dur. Or I believe the Freelancer itself as well. Let's look at this one here. The military version is not available right now, so it's not that relevant to it. So it does have the same people size. It has a larger power plant, of course, because it needs more. It needs more power for the engines, because it has 4 of the TR-5 engines. Which is interesting because the factory power plant is actually a size 4 on all of them. So I wonder if you can later mount a larger one on all of them and the largest one on the Max. It would make sense to me. So Arc Elite 400, 4 times compared to the Arc Duo, and the maneuvering thrusters are the same. So are the shields are a little bit lower, so you have to make sure that you keep that in mind. But I have to say that's interesting, because that means that the shield on the normal one is also the maximum of 4, because it's exactly the same, but you can have a larger shield size on it. Propulsion, well, you've seen already it has 4 Arc Elite 400 hard points. It does have less hard points than the normal one on pylons. That's kinda very confusing. I don't think that the Dur has less than the normal one. I think there must be a mistake. I think that's actually the side ones, the big ones there. Not sure. Now that's the big ones, your unmanned turret. So I don't know where these are on the normal one. And the one that we have also is the manned turret, and that's probably all three have the same. That's pretty much it. Then the shield generator, we looked at that, and the Leaper jump engine compared to the Leaper Pro that the Dürr has for longer transits. And I wonder if you actually can put that one on instead and be more efficient. Would be a really interesting thing to look at. So the standalone chip costs 140, and of course if you want to get the package so you can actually get into the hangar, you need to pledge $155 for it if that is your first chip. So what do I take from that? It is a ship that for me probably fills in the position of pilots that want to go by themselves and do some trade and want to be on a somewhat safe route where you don't have to expect pirates, but you can definitely do hold a little bit of a fire by yourself. It's for the starter of the transport business. If you don't want to or can't afford to get an escort into other places, this is probably one of the starter ships where you can do the risky business with. So here are some nice pictures of it again. Part of that is concept art, part of that is how you see it in the game nowadays. And thanks for watching. Until next time on Thorinus channel. And one more thing, please send me a like and subscribe. I would be really happy to have that from you. And I'll see you next time. Bye.